Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the StarCraft II stage. We've already had some explosive action this morning. It's about to get a whole lot crazier. We've got StarTail Sound versus Liquid Hero fighting for a spot to advance in this tournament. My name is Total Biscuit, joined once again by the mighty Axelav.
So far, we've seen some pretty crazy games today. Nanoa,
oh yeah,
really showing his strength. 4-0 today.
It's kind of ridiculous, really, when you think about it. Nanoa, the guy that was saying before he even came to this tournament, I don't know if I should come because I'm not really feeling prepared. Right.
If you're as good as Nanoa, I guess you don't even need to be that prepared.
Apparently not.
No, just that much talent, of course. We'll see him up against Paul in his next match, but right now it's going to be Hero versus Sound. And both these guys have had some pretty interesting victories on their way. Sound, in fact, every time he's won so far, it's been 2-0.
Yes.
The only maps he's lost were the two maps that he lost in Winner's Round, I think it was 5.
Yeah.
And he's beaten some great players. I mean, he had his revenge match against Golden. Of course, then he went on to beat Heart 2-0 as well.
Yep.
He beat Moonglade 2-0, you know, the top Australian player.
I mean, he cut through Sase and Sage. And Sage, the guy that took Sue out, who was considered to be one of the favorites for this particular tournament. Both Hero and Sound were actually taken out by Hyun, so they've got something in common there, and now, of course, are fighting to stave off elimination. Both of these guys, though, have a fantastic aggressive kind of style. Sound, we've seen throughout this tournament, not only aggressive, but has absurd macro. He is able to attack in three places at once and yet still be able to keep up with his production at home. You rarely ever see him floating any minerals whatsoever. Hero, on the other hand, as we've seen, master of micro, excellent control, and has a lot of very interesting ideas about how this matchup should be played.
It looks like the players are getting ready. Hero warming his hands up in preparation for this to happen. And the first map is going to be Belshir Vestige. We can kick this one off, and it's going to be... this map is really exciting for Terran vs. Protoss. There's so many options both races have at their disposal. Of course, we saw in, I think it was QXC versus Deer, both players did these crazy one-base builds. Of course,
yeah.
Blinkstalker is very viable on this map, and Terran drop play is great as well because the two side passages, you can sneak those medivacs down. And while you're sneaking them down, you'll keep an eye out on if your opponent's doing sneak expansions, proxy buildings, etc.
All right, well, here we go. Belshir Vestige, a map we've seen an awful lot in this tournament. Once more into the breach. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Belshir Vestige. And this man right here, who I know you guys are somewhat of a fan of, and rightfully so, especially considering how well he's been playing up to this point. To the northwest position, in the red trunks, playing Protoss, it is Liquid Hero! His ambition is to get so many trophies, he needs a bigger shelf to keep them on. And he's doing a pretty good job so far. His opponent, on the other hand, often underrated, and that tends to be the mistake of whoever he's facing up against. Fantastic player with a great run so far to the southeast position in the blue trunks playing Terran, StarTail Sound!
And Sound is coming off the back of 2-0 victories over
yep.
other Protoss opponents,
yeah.
Sase and Sage. So he's, I mean, his last four games, 4-0 against Protoss, up against another Protoss in Hero, he's got to be feeling good. Whereas, I mean, Hero, his last game was a match against Hyun.
Yeah.
And that was a defeat.
Yeah, and I mean, I wouldn't necessarily call it a crushing one in the sense of it was not one-sided. It is actually incredibly close. But it seemed crushing because both players played their all that entire. They put everything they had into that match. It was obvious just looking at them. And when one player loses in that scenario, it's just crushing. You could see it on their face. But he was looking extremely bright this morning. It looked like he had gotten over that. He was ready to fight again. He was cheery. So that kind of attitude is always good going into this kind of match.
Looks like nobody's going for anything funny too early on. We're going to see a Reaper expansion from Sound. And of course, Hero is just going to go for the barracks, the gateway, assimilator, cybernetics core. Only single gas so far for Hero. So he may be looking to do a one gas expansion. Some Protosses do it either way. If a Protoss takes a second gas and a Terran scouts it, they have to be aware of different threats. But the
yep.
single gas really says, okay, I'm just going to go straight for that Nexus as fast as possible.
Yeah, I doubt either of these guys want to be aggressive off the bat. We call them both aggressive players, but we are looking at a situation where we're talking about aggression a bit later on, more of mid-game aggression. Interesting. Ah, energy block. I thought, why on earth would you scout when you've got a Reaper? The answer is if you want to engineering block. And this is actually a nice move because, as we were saying before, Hero does want to expand. Note the mineral count is getting very high. Now he's going to be denied that for quite some time. The engineering bay takes quite a lot of time. And what's going to be even more annoying is that Zealot's going to go up there, and then the Reaper's going to pop up and it's going to shoot the Zealot. So it's going to keep that there for quite some time. Extremely irritating to deal with.
One thing that's a little bit more comfortable for Hero than in some situations is that Engineering Bay only got about 30-40% of the way done, so yeah. The Zealot can take out much faster than if it was almost complete.
Well, it looks like the Reaper wants to go and scout and maybe try and take a probe out, which... sound, you sneaky individual. All right, well, he'll be able to regenerate that health momentarily. He'd love to stop that Nexus going down, but as you said, the Engineering Bay block was not as effective as it could have been because it was scouted quickly and it was responded to quickly. If he'd skipped the Zealot, for instance, that may have not been the case.
Zealot and the probe doing their job to try to get that natural up as fast as possible. We can see, while he did make his first Engineering Bay in his opponent's base, he's actually getting a very fast Engineering Bay of his own. Oh, no, the Reaper! You know what? I think Sound just wants to test these combat drugs. Make sure they actually work.
Yeah, apparently they do. It's good stuff. First sample is free. Whatever the case, his control has been great so far and throughout this entire tournament. So it's going to be an absolute treat to watch the control of both of these guys in play here, I think. That's a pretty early plus one, honestly, for Sound. That's interesting. What do you make of that?
It's a very, very fast upgrade. I've seen this build a few times before, and of course, it's nice because you do get those upgrades very quickly, but it does slow your stim pack and, of course, the medevac tech as well. Oh, time warp going down. There's no bunker.
Aggressive from Hero, and rightfully so. He does have the units to make that work. He's not able to get the best angle of fire there, and sacrificing the Zealot for maybe 3, 4, possibly even 5 Marines, assuming he doesn't make a control mistake, which he probably won't, and that's totally worth it.
Notice how Sound first targeted down the Zealot because it had the highest damage output of those three units. Then he went for the Mothership Core, because once you push Mothership Core back, the Protoss was in that high ground vision. Oh, Hero!
Wow, Hero!
He was busy looking at his base, trying to deal with the Reaper, I think, and miscontrolled that Stalker, and all of a sudden this early aggression from Hero has started to backfire a bit.
That's why you don't mess with Sound's control, always multitasking. That's been his strength throughout this entire tournament, always dropping in 2 or 3 positions, attacking, and never letting up.
Oh,
but nice catch by Hero. Very, very nice indeed. Man, this is a joy to watch already. Two masters of control going at it.
That Reaper slipped out of one situation, slipped out of a second, but the third time the probes did catch him and pin him down, allow the Stalker to finish the job. Now, Hero's going for a very fast Warp Prism, so he's really going to try to use that upgraded Warp Prism speed that recently came through in the last patch to try to outmaneuver Sound, maybe pick off an SCV here, an SCV there. It's not something that's going to end the game, a Warp Prism harassment, just a few gateway units, but if he keeps Sound on the back foot, he can also scout Sound and know the timing of the third command center and or the medevac timing.
Ah, there's a couple of sentries in this, so there's an awful lot of interesting options. Interesting that it's Sentry Stalker as opposed to Sentry Zealot. Sentry Zealot is generally... he's gonna miss it by the looks of it. No, he isn't! How did he smell that?
I think it was maybe, in a watchtower.
Yeah, he must have seen it just on the edge there. It looked like it was out of range. I guess not, but he now knows it's coming. He knows he can't catch it, but he knows it's there, so he'll be able to respond.
And I think he's figuring Hero will have less at home with that, with the Warp Prism on the counterattack.
Right, but with the Photon Overcharge, it makes no difference. You know, unshielded, unstimmed Marines are not going to be able to fight that. And the sentries, I imagine, are designed to block off that ramp, but at this point, he doesn't really have an opportunity to make that. There it is!
Cutting off the reinforcements from the main, and natural is totally exposed. There's a bunker with a single Marine in it. All these Marines on the outside, you're actually doing a decent job against the Stalkers, but if Hero can keep warping the sentries, a little bit of a miscontrol, but Hero not pulling those three Stalkers back by his natural, but the big story is the natural Sound. He can't mine from there.
No, and if he keeps taking damage like that, he will flat out lose it. He's actually forced to lift, and he's lifting it away from his reinforcements, but towards the SCVs that can repair it, and there is a bunker in between that. But now, the aggression is on. The warp-in's directly into the natural expansion here. And Hero realizes that bunker has barely anything in it. It's going to eliminate it almost immediately. The SCV's moving a little bit further out there. Wow, how do you get rid of this? If you risk going down the ramp, you could be cut in half and destroyed, but he's now got medevacs. He'll be able to lift over it.
That's right, but he's got to make sure he doesn't lose too many of those SCVs. Oh, I think he's lost 4 or 5 or maybe even 6 of those guys in that engagement.
Yeah, 5 workers down. That's already pretty bad considering the amount of mining time that was lost in the process. That's messy.
The one thing that's going well is he's going to trap this army.
Here he goes.
Oh, he's coming in here.
Coming in from multiple angles very nicely. Don't we be able to catch the Warp Prism? No, nothing can catch the Warp Prism. Off it goes. And at least he clears up his natural there, but he did take a significant amount of damage. The Warp Prism is still there. He's going to try and drop to do damage. He's trapped it in place. Will he be able to sneak out?
You know, I don't think it can. With rings on both sides of that, there's no airspace to step around him. In fact, Sound's producing a Viking. So once that Viking comes out, Warp Prism... found an angle.
He's trying to give it the slip. Will he be able to do it? And he'd have gotten away with it too if it weren't for those pesky Marines.
Sound was so on top of that, immediately stimming and getting ready to intercept. Oh, he's going, trying to go. Nope. Oh.
If he gets out. Whoa, Sound lets him out.
He let him out. One single Marine says, hey guys, he's over here.
Nah, we don't mind. It's because the Viking's after it, but can it catch it?
No, War Prism's too fast now.
War Prism speed. That nice little upgrade.
One more Marine trying to do what he can for his country.
Man.
Not quite enough.
Sound is so good mana, isn't he?
He is. He is. You know, he's like, you know what? All right. I know I killed a bunch of Zealots and Stalkers back there. I'll let the rest of you guys get home to tell the tale of the, you know, the scariness of the Terran Force.
Yeah, exactly. Send them back. Make sure they never return. Well, so we're going to see some interest. Nice. All right. Bit of overkill to get that one probe. But hey, he was, of course, going towards the main base. Was able to pick off that probe before it was able to establish third base. Sees the Colossus going in right there.
Ah, that's a bold drop.
Yeah, I mean, that is a bold drop, and it's not going to work at all. And he's forced out there, but he didn't lose that much. He only lost a couple of units there. He was definitely in control of that drop regardless.
I think the medevacs and units inside him had different plans. Medevacs are like, go down there.
No, I don't want to do that.
There's Zealous down there. We don't want to drop right on top of
him. I just imagine that medevacs just have this giant trap door to just kick the units out of. So we've got a third base established up to the top right there. Sound has not taken his third as of yet, but is powering forward with his production. Very typical Sound style, the double engineering bay, which he's actually not getting anything out of yet. He's got the gas to start an upgrade, but he doesn't have the minerals because that is Sound's macro in a nutshell. He will spend till he can't spend anymore. And now he's going to try and take that third base out. There's nothing to actually respond to that. That will be a cancellation, no question. Nice little grab there by Sound.
This is something a lot of Protoss players have been doing lately, saying, you know what? Yes, it's hard to defend three bases, but I'll put the Nexus down. I'll focus on defending the drops in a main and natural. Worst case, it gets canceled. So that was a great pickup by Sound to take down a Nexus. But, you know, it's at the end of the day, it's only 100 mana loss from Hero. It's not a big deal. It's always worth it to try to put that Nexus up, and worst case, it gets canceled.
Yeah, and I mean, you're stretching your opponent across the map. You're giving them more targets to fire at that don't involve your mineral lines, which is always a nice thing to do. And if he focuses on your main base and you defend it, as you said, you can get your third up, and that would be great. So it's a nice little gamble.
Looks like Sound was looking for probably a Colossus pickoff there. Didn't quite get it. Hero pushes him back. And, you know, Hero's snuck himself into a nice little supply lead.
Yep.
A lot of that based on that early aggression that really put Sound on the back foot economically.
Yeah, and it's a nice composition as well. It's extremely Zealot heavy with three Colossus. Viking count's currently only at four. It's about to be at six with a plus one upgrade on the way. I love the fact that Sound is trying to take those Colossus out with small little attacks. But every now and again, that's not going to work. And a great blink there by Hero, and doesn't quite get the medevac. But that was a nice move nonetheless. And Sound can't really afford to keep losing these units. Here comes a Warp Prism harass, full of Zealots, going straight to the middle line. The response time is nice and quick there from Sound, though. That probably won't even get anything done, really. Warp Prism gets chased off. Maybe it gets away. No, I don't think so.
And one more volley. There it goes. Warp Prism taken out. Zealots taken out. But Hero's still looking very good. His third of them was done. Sound still only on two orbital commands. So Sound really has to make an attack happen. And Hero's now adding Storm into his Colossi.
Nice. I mean, being able to get up to that end game composition. It's weird to say end game of 15 minutes, but the mixture of Colossus and Templar, those great units with excellent AoE. And we've got Hellbats being added in, which I like very much, and a very Marauder heavy force as well, which is going to be great against both of those. They'll be able to tank a lot more Storm damage, they'll be able to do a lot more damage to the Colossus, and of course they don't get killed quite as quickly by the Zealots, but they're not going to kill the Zealots as quickly either, which is why he's adding the Hellbats in the first place. You need something to clear that out.
Now he's looking to attack, but I think by the time he crosses the map, that Storm tech is going to be done. And with Storm, that's a very powerful
Stalker hit squad comes in, picks off a Viking, and just runs off. We've seen Blink Stalker action from Hero this entire tournament. They're so elusive. He's able to get out of situations that you wouldn't think would be possible.
SCV's joined the fight here. Sound's on two bases. He has to make something now. Is he really going to try to go up this ramp? But Hero...
Hero doesn't have anything there to stop him.
Yeah, he's not trying to guard that ramp. He's actually looking like he wants to sacrifice the third base, potentially. Oh, he's got Templar positioned at third. Those could flank from behind. He's got Templar the natural, too.
This is about to get very interesting, isn't it? SCVs are off the line, so this is pretty much all or nothing. Eats a Storm, not a bad one. Storm forward right there. Where are those other Templar behind? Could we see a flank coming in? He's trying to engage against the Natural Expansion. Here it goes. Storm in the middle. Doesn't do too much damage. Zealots coming in from the side as well. Hellbat's trying to defend from all sides. A big Storm in the center. Another Storm to the side. He is sandwiched between both armies.
Oh, Hero. Great Storms. The three Colossi are still alive. There's no Vikings left. He sounds trying to push in here, but I think Hero may have too much.
Absolutely not. He cannot do it. He is going to take a lot of damage from those Marauders, but he can't push all the way through, especially with reinforcements coming in. However, he's going to make a fight of it. And if probes get sacrificed, maybe, just maybe, Sound gets back into this, but there's such a huge deficit in workers here.
Oh, all the medevacs are dropping down, too.
Well, well, a convincing performance already from Hero in game one. Sound staying on two bases for so long there, allowing Hero to get the third up and realizing, oh, well, there's not much you can do from this position other than try and destroy something. Do you think it was the right move to go straight for the natural, or do you think he maybe should have tried the third again?
I think as long as you get up that ramp, that often as you try to go up that first ramp, you can get force field, but once he was on the high ground, going for the natural is the right move. I mean, if he even spends 30 seconds killing the third base, all of a sudden it's three more storms and a fight looks even worse for Sound. Yeah. Really, that timing, you pretty much have to hit before Storm. Unfortunately, he was about 10, 15 seconds late. And when you have an early game where you have to lift your natural, you lose 5, 6 SCVs, you can't even build SCVs from one command center, so you lose the build time, another 5 or 6 SCVs. I mean, all your times are thrown off there, and that's really what happened to Sound.
Yeah, certainly. Hero really messed with him in a big way there. That initial aggression was absolutely fantastic. Sound, for once, on the back foot, and actually drops a map to a Protoss player right here. Not looking as confident as he was before, but will he be able to bring it back? We'll find out after this break, folks. This is MLG Anaheim.